Hi, so I'm making this video to answer many of your questions regarding how to get good placements after your bachelor's, how to prepare for it, what are the resources you need, how to do strategic planning to get a good placement. So before starting into it, I want you all to know that if it was easy, everyone would got it. So that's an important thing you should remember. And second thing is, have a purpose, have a goal, or have a vision after 5 years where you want to work, what kind of work culture or a lifestyle you want, and you should focus working towards that dream. Now I will take you through my journey, how I got into college, how I prepared myself to get a good placement. After 12th, like everyone, I wanted to enjoy my college life, and for that I traveled as far as from Kerala to Punjab to pursue my Btech in computer science. I know I wanted to do computer science because I was always curious about technology, how apps are developed, how websites are working, how softwares are created. So I was curious about this and I wanted to know about it, so I pursued Btech in computer science. And once I reached in college in my first year, what I learned is placements are not as easy as it seems, and it's not as glamorous as it is shown, right? Why is that? Because first thing I got to know is there are two types of companies, service-based companies and product-based companies. So what are service-based companies? Service-based companies are companies that provide their services to other clients, like for example, Infosys, TCS, Tech Mahindra, etc. And the package for a fresher from these companies are around 3 to 6 lakhs per annum. And the second group is product-based companies, which includes companies like Google, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, etc. And the package includes somewhere around, you can say, 10 lakhs to 35 lakhs per annum. Maybe more nowadays. And I will be focusing on how to prepare for product-based companies and what you all should do in each year of your college life to get into that. So for the students who are in their 12th or who have completed their 12th, I want to say that you should choose a university or college that can provide a good placement, and that's very important. And once you get into your college, let's say you are in your first year, the things you have to do in your first years are following. You should figure out your university or college, make some good or great friends, have a good circle, figure out what is your passion. You should explore all your options, participate in all your extracurricular activities, sports, arts, and in the in your career, you should figure out what kind of work you want after 5 years. Do you want to be a full stack developer? Do you want to pursue a career in machine learning, or maybe you want to be an app developer or web designer? Anything. So you should explore all of this, and you should know where your heart lies, and you should focus on that. And in the academic side, please learn the programming language C and C++. Why? C and C++ can really take you into depth of programming, how programming actually works, how memory allocations are done, how data structures are created, and how hardware and software are interacting, how compilers are helping you. So this stuff is really important for you to be a good software engineer. Okay, and you should really learn about this. So, and obviously you should enjoy your life in your college to have a good or great college life. Do traveling, eat a lot of food, have fun with your friends too. Once you are in second year, you have to work towards your passion. Let's say your passion is to be a machine learning engineer or a full stack developer, or you want to work for a company called X. So how can you prepare yourself to get into these positions? So that should be your primary focus in your second year. And for that, the first and the foremost important thing you have to do is start with a project. It can be a mini project, it can be a big project, doesn't matter. You should start with it somehow. If you are looking to be a full stack developer, start with a project that has front end, back end, develop a website that is just, you can show to others like you have created something. If you want to be a machine learning engineer, create some small programs that utilizes machine learning algorithms, figure out how it works, stuff like that. In my case, I wanted to work with natural language processing. So I created a virtual assistant with whom I can talk, I can interact, I can do all the mathematics, or I can ask the laptop to play some songs or surf the website or things like that. Basically a small version of Siri or Alexa. And this was in 2014-15. And for me, that was my passion. So I started with that project. And my couple of my friends who are interested to be web designer started designing great, beautiful websites. Some of my friends started building their own portfolio and they implemented their full stack skills they wanted to do in this project. So start with an idea initially. You can't build a project in one day or one week or maybe in a month. For me, the project took around 4 semesters, which is approximately 2 years of time. So it can take time. So if you do mini projects, maybe you can do it in months. It's a big project, maybe it can take years. But all that matters is you should start with the project. Once your idea is there, start working towards it. Now, apart from project, what you have to focus on now is learning data structures and algorithms. You might learn the theory in your colleges, in your semesters, but you should start implementing the theory in actual programming. So for that, you should go to platforms like LeetCode, HackerRank, Geeks for Geeks, Google Code Jam, etc., where you have to solve actual programming questions. And these programming questions are what asked in actual interviews. So you should focus on that. Try solving them. Try to solve at least one question in a day, or maybe 20 questions in a month of varying difficulties. Easy, start with easy questions, go to medium, then hard. Play around the data structures, understand how it works, how it is implemented. And it's a long process, so you start in your second year, continue it till you get a job. So it should be a habit, a habitual process you should do. And apart from that, focus on your college life too. Have fun, spend time with your friends. Now, let's say you are in your third year. Third year is just continuation of second year. You have to follow the same process, start with the second or third project. Have a couple of other mini projects, which are different from your first projects. Explore different areas of expertise you want to dive in, you have to learn. You can also learn new things from YouTube or... mostly what I did is I learned new skills from YouTube, mostly watching videos. You can also get free certification courses, hackathon, participate in hackathons, implement your ideas there, and also continue doing the LeetCode or HackerRank, whatever platform you are working on. Focus on your projects. Exhibit these projects in various platforms as much as you can. Go participate in hackathons or some events where you can showcase your projects. And that would be a great way to express your ideas to others, get feedback, improve it, learn new topics or new skills and implement it again on top of that. It will give you a larger depth of knowledge. Also, you should focus on your soft skills. So you should learn how to speak to your colleagues, how to speak to your interviewers, how to present your idea, how to present yourself well in front of others. And this is the grooming period, and you should groom yourself very well. I remember one of my HOD in college says that you should consider yourself as a person who is going to get married. And so how you will walk? You will be dressing well, you will be behaving well, you will be overall your appearance will be groomed well, your attitude will be better because you need to get your partner, right? So think like that. You are in that grooming stage. So think you are in that stage, and you should start behaving as a well-groomed man or girl. Okay. Now, at the end of third year, I believe the companies will start coming for placements. They will hire a few students for internships in their fourth year or for the jobs after the fourth year. And so the end of third year to the fourth year, so this time period is called the placement season. And in this time, it's where you have to show off your skills, right? So you sit for the placements in the companies you really want to work. If these companies are not coming into your colleges, apply with your resume in their web portals. Okay, so for example, if Google is not coming into your company, go to Google's career website and apply there. That's one way. Second thing is you need to have a good LinkedIn profile. Put a good picture, not the Instagram picture, but a good professional picture. Fill out your bio properly, write about your projects, all the projects you did, what all skills you have used, what all languages, what all technologies you have done in that. Describe it in detail in LinkedIn. Upload your resume in LinkedIn. Have a good profile so that if the recruiter who is looking at you from the off-campus placement can know, okay, this guy has something better. So before placement session starts, you have to have a good resume, good LinkedIn profile, and a good soft skills. Okay, now interviews are pretty straight in product-based companies. They will ask about, there'll be a round to get to know yourself, and the other rounds will be mostly on data structures and algorithms. So these are the questions that will be similar to the questions you have solved in LeetCode or HackerRank. So you're doing LeetCode for past few years or few months, I would say, and that would really help you on cracking the interview questions. Once that is done, voila, you got your placements, right? And I'll be making more in detail video on how to prepare for interviews, what topics to cover, what data structure you should focus on, how it is done actually, in a separate video. I don't want to make this very long. So I hope you got a good idea on the journey from 12th to the final year or to the placement season of campus placements, and how to better prepare yourself. So I would recap it again. In your first year, try to know about your college, your academia, your friends, your purpose, your vision, and have a good time at the college. In the second year, start with the project, learn some new skills, start improving your soft skills too, learn data structures, and start with LeetCode. Third year, continue whatever you're doing in your second year, but with more projects, more question solving, and more soft skills. And in the fourth year, on the end of third year, or in the fourth year, prepare yourself for the interviews. And that's it. I hope I was able to help you or guide you through this journey. And if you have any questions or doubts regarding things, please comment them below. And if you want me to cover any more additional topics, if you have any other doubts, just tell me about it. I'll make videos on that. And I want to ask you guys if you want me to make videos on programming questions and how to solve them. If you want, I can make it, but I see there are already so many great videos in YouTube. You can look at NeetCode YouTube channel also, which I really like. Yeah, apart from that, if you have any questions, just comment down. I'll be answering it. Yeah, I hope I was able to help you guys. Have a good day.